You need to get off the streets. The agency knows my secure locations, and they will be searching for us. This is the safest place I know.
Can I come with you?
You need to hide, till I know what's going on.
Oh, it was you who called?
Yes.
Oh, you must be Victoria. Come on in, child.
Thank you for your help. This girl is important. Take this.
We will take good care of her, my son.
Diana said you need that necklace. Don't lose it.
Will you come back?
I'll be watching. Birdie, we need to meet.
Your actions precede you, my man. Yeah, I gotta say, I admire a man with the courage to shit where he eats. I'm guessing you're in need of some information, and I just might be willing to play ball. But first, I got a favor to ask. You listening? Sweet. Well, see, this is local upstart calling himself the King of Chinatown. Not exactly the understated type. I would really like him to hand in his resignation, if you catch my drift.
Resides at the pagoda in the center of town, where a unit of dirty cops guard his every move. And he rarely leaves the crowd, except to meet up with his dealer in a pad overlooking the square. Yeah, he also got a swanky European ride parked in a nearby alley. And that's all I got, Holmes. So, call me back when you're done. Got it?
Birdie, once the agency's top intelligence man, in order to protect the girl, I need him as my eyes and ears. But his service... Birdie.
Thank you. Shit! Not again. Okay, here we go again. Who's there? Show yourself! Turn around and go back where you came from. Step away, sir.
Can't see the perp. Over.
Birdie, once the agency's top intelligence man. In order to protect the girl, I need him.
Please, please. Give me Buckle up. Let's find the son of a bitch.
Yeah? What's up? No, I didn't. He called me. Ah, crap. Did I hit it again? Oh, sorry. No, nothing new. Okay, out. I hate when I do that.
Spare some change for an old fool. Ugh, God, there's coffee in there, you fucker!
So what brings your mean ass to my home?
I need information.
Well, that's my business. Information. You need information, I find information.
At a price, of course.
You're damn right at a price. Of course.
Girl named Victoria. The agency wants her bad. I need to know why.
No, wait. The agency. You want me to snoop around the agency? Were you crazy? Yeah, you crazy. All right, what is it worth to you?
Name your price.
Well, tools.
Listen to the city. If anyone mentions the girl, you know what to do.
I'll call you.
You do that. Yes.
Terminus Hotel, room 899.
So ask my bird the question, Holmes,
And the answer came back in the shape of a name. Blake Dexter. An arms industry VIP who seems to have taken a special interest in your girl. Dexter occupies the Terminus's top floor, and his thugs have the place sealed off tight. Still, a man of your skills and resources should be able to find several access points. Good luck, Holmes.
You know that guy? Man, he's got some balls. Wouldn't catch me messing around with electricity in a flooded pit. Not for $1 million, no sir. Shit.
Man, that's Joe for you. He ain't like a living legend downtown. Would you believe he was struck by lightning once? Damn straight. Bastard walked away with a scratch, too. Some of the guys say he can even turn on a light bulb just by snapping his fingers.
Oh.
We just came from upstairs. Who's this VIP guy taking up the entire 8th floor? And he brought a whole gang of shaved gorillas. Real creep jobs. You got the sweet gig down here, man. You want my ringside tickets, don't you?
Well, I was gonna ask for a coffee and a Danish, but now that you mention it...
Stop yours, Jerry.
a resourceful son of a bitch. Ooh, you're approaching the lion's den now. Thugs you encountered are gonna have the 8th floor completely under lockdown. Now Blake Dexter, he enjoys his privacy. And sneaking into 899 is not gonna be an easy task. And to make matters worse, Dexter's protected by a seriously nasty bodyguard who will not, I repeat, not take kindly to trespassers. So you should probably look to get off at a lower floor and look for a more subtle entry point. But what am I saying? A pro like you, you probably got the whole thing figured out, don't you? Alright, go get him.
Sorry, sir. We've had elevator problems all day. They're being fixed as we speak.
Are the stairwells secure?
Uh-huh. Sealed up tight. Nobody disturbs Mr. Dexter without our permission.
Good. And no incidents, you hear me? I want this operation to go as smooth as possible. No drinking, no fighting, and no banging the maze. That means you.
Come back later.
Oh, no. Come on in.
All right. Jesus.
Just keep your dick in your pants, all right? Yo. Yeah, I got you. What you need? You're joking, man. Are you nuts? So I'm supposed to just cover you?
When I was a kid, I'd lie up on the roof over the porch, you know, looking out at the clouds and listen to my sister play the violin. Back then, I wanted the world, you know. Couldn't wait to grow up, go places, make something of myself. And now I realize, probably the happiest time of my life.
Let the woman do her job. What's wrong with me?
You're not a very good salesman, are you?
No.
Thank you. think they're gonna jump off your shelves. They'll leap right off. Just pounding shoes, cascading down. 40% done. I mean, Ron, stay with me. Listen. Half the lot, then. Half the lot, 45% off, and that's my final offer. Now, there is no call for that kind of language. I understand your skepticism, but I am telling you...
Wad keeps messing up my energy flow. Hello? Who, man, is like spreading bad vibes out here? Hello, anyone?
Don't go sneaking around like that. What a sleazy idiot. Thank you, but you really need help.
We already dominated him. And that is why I'm paid you so much, Levi.
You worry your pretty little head with all those numbers. Now, I want this fucking girl, okay? Now, I have a good one.
Her name is Victoria, and she's worth a lot of fucking money. Nah, she's some kind of enhanced wonder child or something. Point is, we go in, we grab her, we hang on to her until they give us the ransom.
Sounds like something you came up with in one of your labs.